So now we will discuss in this video about obturator nerve. Already we discussed about erector compartment of thigh. We have three compartments of the front of thigh, medial compartment of thigh and posterior compartment of thigh. So medial compartment of thigh is only called as erector compartment of thigh. In the erector compartment of thigh, we discussed few muscles. So the next point in erector compartment of thigh is nerve. The chief nerve for the erector compartment, that is the medial compartment of thigh, is obturator nerve. For front of thigh, we discuss that it was femoral nerve. Now here we will discuss about obturator nerve. So whenever we will discuss about nerves in anatomy, we should go from its origin, about its course, and then its branches. So talking about the origin of obturator nerve, it is arising from lumbar plexus. Already we discussed in one of our videos about lumbar plexus also. So lumbar plexus has some branches. Remember it with the help of that trick called in India, Gandhiji opens lottery factory. That means II stands for ilioinguinal nerve, iliohypogastric nerve, genitofemoral nerve. O stands for obturator nerve. L stands for lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh, and F stands for femoral nerve. These all were the branches of lumbar plexus. Okay, that already we discussed. So one of the branch from the lumbar plexus is obturator nerve. That's what we are going to discuss. One more point for the about its origin is that to remember root value. So root value is from L2, L3 and L4. So one more point is here. Femoral nerve also has the root value L2, L3 and L4. So the difference only is that femoral nerve arises from the posterior divisions of this L2, L3 and L4 spinal nerves. But this obturator nerve arises from the posterior divisions of spinal nerves L2, L3 and L4. Okay. So now let's start with origin. Remember, from the anterior divisions of posterior division, that is for femoral nerve. You can remember F and P, that is same root value but posterior divisions. Same root value, anterior division is obturator nerve. Anterior divisions of L2, L3 and L4. So let's suppose in this typical diagram, this what we have L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. And let's go. This is what we have is sacrum. Okay. So from L2, that means from here, L2, L3 and L4, what we are getting is the nerve fibers. That means these fibers will run together. That means the spinal nerve L2, L3, L2, L3, L4 spinal nerves will run. Then they will give some anterior divisions. Each one will give anterior division. And each one will give posterior divisions. Their anterior divisions joined together to form the obturator nerve. So this is what we got, obturator nerve. Same, their posterior divisions will join together to form, let's suppose these blue structures are all posterior divisions of the spinal nerves. They join together to form the femoral nerve. And now we already know this femoral nerve is the chief nerve for the anterior compartment. Now this red structure, that is obturator nerve, will be supplying the structures present in the middle compartment. Okay. So now about its origin, that's all for here. Now for course, we should have some imagination here. That is, this is not a 3D diagram, that's why I can't explain it. Just remember, when we will discuss about back anatomy, in that we will discuss one muscle, that is psoas major muscle. So that psoas major muscle, some substance is present somewhere here. It will descend like this. So remember, psoas major muscle is present somewhere here on the back, that is from vertebrates. So this obturator nerve actually runs in between the psoas major muscle, in the substance of psoas major muscle. So if you remember here, it lies in the psoas major, then it descends in the pelvic cavity. Posteriorly sacrum, anteriorly these two hip bones are joining together to form pubic symphysis. So and what we have pubic symphysis and then posterior sacrum, in between them what we have pelvic cavity. So this structure here, what we have, let's suppose pelvic cavity. So this obturator nerve then enters into pelvic cavity. From pelvic cavity, Now
it is related to the inner surface of this hip bone. Okay, now it's in relation with the inner surface of this hip bone. So what it will do now, it will descend down in the pelvic cavity. Here somewhere what we have, this is obturator foramen. This obturator foramen is covered by one membrane that is called as obturator membrane. Okay, this is what we have, let's suppose obturator membrane. Obturator membrane. Here one more additional point you have to learn is one muscle that is called as obturator externus. Obturator externus muscle. This muscle actually is, it is not a adductor compartment muscle, it is a posterior compartment muscle. But here we have one relation with the obturator nerve, that's why we will discuss it. Obturator externus muscle arises from the obturator membrane. Okay, it originates from the obturator membrane, and these fibers will pass posteriorly. These fibers will pass posterior to the femur. That means they will pass laterally first and then posterior to the femur. On the posterior surface of femur, at the upper end, we have one point that is called as intertrochanteric fossa. Intertrochanteric fossa on the posterior aspect of femur. This is the anterior aspect. Let's suppose on posterior aspect behind this, we have one landmark that is called as intertrochanteric fossa somewhere here. Okay, intratrochanteric fossa. So this obturator externus muscle actually originates from this obturator membrane and gets inserted on the intratrochanteric fossa like this. These fibers will pass posteriorly to the femur. So this muscle. Okay. Now what happens? We discuss now this obturator nerve, red color structure is in pelvic cavity. It will descend down in the obturator foramen. It will pierce the obturator membrane. It will pierce the obturator membrane. And here it will give two divisions, anterior divisions and posterior divisions. So this is, let's suppose this is what we have, obturator externus muscle. Behind this, somewhere here, this obturator nerve is dividing into two branches, divisions, that is anterior division and posterior division. So let's suppose this is anterior division. It is anterior because it lies anterior to the obturator externus muscle, and it gives one posterior division which actually pierces this obturator externus muscle. That means this muscle will get pierced. It will pierce this muscle and then run medially. That is posterior division of the obturator nerve. This is anterior division and this is posterior division of the obturator nerve. Now that's all for branches here. Now only about their supply. That means anterior division will supply which muscles, posterior division will supply which muscles. So in adductor compartment we already discussed, we have muscles named adductor longus, adductor magnus, adductor brevis, pectineus, and then what we have, gracilis. Let's suppose adductor magnus, adductor longus, adductor brevis, pectineus and gracilis. So all these muscles are present in the adductor compartment. So they all have the nerve supply from the obturator nerve. Plus some have other nerves also. That means they are hybrid muscles also, but that's not point here. So to discuss the anterior division supplies gracilis, pectineus, adductor longus, and adductor brevis. Okay. So now if we will discuss this anterior division, it descends down. We know from here which muscles are arising. From here adductor longus is arising, descends down, its fibers are from here adductor magnus, from here pectineus, then here gracilis. These muscles origin points we already discussed in muscle part. Okay, so remember these muscles will be present somewhere here. So this anterior division will descend down. This anterior division will descend down and it will supply the particular muscle. That means which muscle, adductor longus muscle, adductor brevis muscle, adductor pectineus muscle and gracilis muscle will be supplied by this anterior division. Okay, and then it will end. By supplying this muscle, it will end. About posterior division, posterior division supplies only adductor magnus and also adductor brevis if it is not supplied by anterior division. This adductor brevis is point to remember here. It, sometimes this is supplied by anterior division and sometimes it is supplied by posterior division. If it will be supplied by anterior division, then posterior division will not supply it. So that point you have to remember. Erector magnus, one muscle that is by posterior division. Erector brevis and one muscle that is obturator externus. This is not the adductor compartment muscle, it is the muscle of gluteal region, obturator externus. It is also supplied by the posterior division of obturator nerve. So that was about the obturator nerve here. Actually, if you will draw the muscles once and then if you will draw the obturator nerve, you will understand very clearly. Just remember this course and remember this division, anterior division, it runs anterior to the obturator externus and posterior division, after arising from obturator foramen, piercing obturator membrane, it pierces the obturator externus muscle. Now, one more structure. For reference, you can take in BD thoracic also. That is accessory obturator nerve. Accessory obturator nerve is only present in 30% individuals. That means out of 100, only 30% individuals will have this accessory obturator nerve. Many of us will not have it. So that point, just remember is obturator, if this accessory obturator nerve has root value, that is L3, L4, and it descends down. Here I told you this obturator nerve lies in the substance of psoas major muscle. Okay, I told you here it is lies in the substance of psoas major muscle. But this accessory obturator nerve runs at the middle border of psoas major and then descends down and up to here at the superior boundary of pubic ramus. It ends by giving three branches. One will supply the hip joint, one will supply the pectineus part here, and one will supply or one will join with the anterior division. So that was the anterior division. Remember about it. Remember about accessory obturator nerve. That's all. Now about this posterior division. This posterior division, after